Okay, I'm gonna make two batches of Bob's bread. So I have two bowls. It's the biggest bowl I have. Both of them are. First thing you want to do is cook the cereals. There's two different kinds of cereals.
It doesn't matter all that much.
You just need yeast.
Yeast.
Good yeast.
Bread fresh machine.
Yeast. That's a tablespoon. This goes here. And there's two of those. So it'd be like two packets of yeast. So I'll put a little lukewarm water in the mixing bowl and dissolve the yeast. So I'm gonna put lukewarm water. Add the honey and molasses to the yeast. And it requires a third, fourth cup of honey and a third, fourth cup of molasses. And I'm doubling everything.
How come I can't see you in this?
I don't know. Do you even have, it's not even blinking red. I don't even think it's on.
It says rec as in R-E-C.
How come I can't see anything?
I don't know. Because you're old.
Okay.
Oh. Molasses.
This is plantation molasses.
Ew, it looks like tar.
Yeah, it's pretty.
Tar and hot cereal and yeast. Yummy, yummy. This will be some tasty bread.
Add the molasses and the honey. I'm making two batches of this. The yeast and the water. The warm water and the yeast went in first. Okay, so now we're going to add the cooked cereals, the millet, and the 7-grain.
This is millet. It's still a little dry. Millet's the hardest part to cook.
Don't light yourself on fire.
Light myself on fire.
Okay, this one. This was the 7-grain cereal, and it's pasty, but it's cooked. That's how it should be. As long as it's moist. I don't think it's an exact science. I just think when it all comes down to it, it's the way it feels. As long as all this stuff is in there.
That's Bob.
Michael, you're filming the wrong stuff. Okay, this is the 7-grain cereal. Okay, so I'm mixing the molasses, the honey, the yeast, and the grains.
Apparently
that are cooked
something
cereals.
Is being
there's mixed. All kinds of grain here. This is the cooked cereal.
Cat.
She has now put some germs into the recipe.
It's wheat.
They're wheat germs, but they're still germs. Something's going on over here. As you can see, there is a bag.
It's sesame seeds.
Let's follow the journey of the bag.
Okay.
It seems as if the contents of the bag are being entered into the concoction. But then Mrs. Tracy accidentally entered an extra ingredient into the concoction. Chemical X.
A half a cup of this.
Let's examine it. It appears as though this
is
requires half a cup. The whole point of this. It's so. You can go to the bathroom.
That's good bread.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's actually filled with laxatives.
And this is
natural laxatives.
The result, if you go to a store and just buy bread.
If you have any cancerous.
The result, if you try to make it yourself.
Anytime.
As you can see.
It's just gonna go pass on out.
Always purchase your bread. Or you'll end up making something like this.
I'm gonna put in soy flour. And this is optional, you don't have to put it in. And sometimes it's hard to find. The fox went out on a terrain
night. You pray for the moon to give him light for many miles. Examine.
When in doubt, half a cup.
As a mother explains to no one what she's doing. She could have her own cooking show. Two. I was counting, Mom. I've been filming. Everyone can see on the internet. You only put in two. One. No, everyone sees. You only put one in. Everyone will know that you can't count. Grab the great goose by the neck. No, that was two. One.
That really was one, wasn't it?
No.
Seriously? Don't mess with me.
That was one.
Why does that look like way more than one?
Because you can't count. You were on three, Mom.
I put two in here for sure. Now I'm just not sure if I put two in here.
No, I know you put one in there, Mom. I was counting for you.
Yeah.
No, really. Mom, you only put one in there. Yeah, I'm positive. Now, grab the Pyrex cup and transport it from there to there.
And three cups of the daddy, go back again, for it must be a mighty fine sound. The cut of the goose with a fork and a knife, and they never had such a supper on their life, and the little bones chewed on the bones. Three. One.
This isn't fun.
I got hair in my mouth.
Don't get hair in the bread or no one will eat it.
That'll eat it.
That'll only eat it if you burn it.
Okay. I have one more cup of water to do an inch of six.
One.
Seven. Eight.
Two. As you can see, my mom obviously doesn't know how to count. One. Look at that.
Stop it! It's glorious complete! One and a half cup short of all the flour needed. And it's this sticky. Like that.
This is gonna take a while. As you can see.
It's a big project.
Now back to the entertaining stuff. Four Cokes go in. And now we continue with our bread making. I'm aware of how boring this is. That's why I've added this narration. Notice that this is way beyond 2.5 cups.
See, at this point, it is very sticky still. Actually, you probably can't see that.
Catch it. This is a big ball of dirt that my mom has concocted.
Can I see it?
All of this came.
Stop!
Unlike the guy in Chex Quest from here.
That game makes me sick. I feel like throwing up just by watching
it's because he's got a spoon in the game and he kills the aliens.
Well, how can you still know about Chex Quest? You haven't played that in years. I don't even know if you were old enough to remember that game.
Are you serious? I used to play that all the time.
When? Where? You remember living in Sultan?
Yes.
Stop. You are messing this up! Stop it! Hear me count, or Michael count, ignore all that. Follow the recipe. 10.5 cups of flour for 3 bowls. I'm making 6,
that's why there's 2 bowls. That wasn't really my mom, it was a robot alien. Ignore everything that she says.
Okay,
Now she claims that she's cleaning up. Want to kill yourself after doing something like this. But I insist, please refrain. The results in the end, as you can see, are well, kind of not really worth it, but at least you enjoyed yourself, right? Much better.
Then stand 45 minutes after you form that ball with the oil. And then you turn it a few times, you knead it for 5 minutes, flatten it out again, you divide it in sections, and then you stick it in the pans. If you make loaves, you let it rise for another 20, 30 minutes and you bake it for 40.
You bake it.
I'm making you throw up, aren't I, audience? And we're back! Now, watch as we examine these empty bread trays. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them. Now, as we left the bread in these pots and bowls of such, they have risen. They've been growing.
Punch.
Oh my god.
That's what you do.
She just destroyed ours. The bread is now leaving its home, entering the countertop again. The dough. My mom is moving the dough around, kneading it. We're back to another exciting episode of Dough Land 5000.
Okay, you want to get it in 3 equal parts as much as possible.
As much as possible.
Okay, I'm just going to twist this. Here.
That's some flour there. Man, if I saw that sitting in the toilet, I'd scream like a little girl.
Would you stop?
We return to our hero. As she continues making more logs. On the next episode of Cook Time, will Mom find a way to fit the bread into 6 pans when she only has 3 pieces?
Oh, I have a whole other bowl. And it's sticking.
Find out next time. And pay no attention to that. Right. I think you get the general picture of what's going on here.
And then you pinch like this.
Bread, logs.
And then you pinch.
Pinching. We return to our hero where we find Mrs. Tracy is on the last bread log. As she finishes this bread log, watch carefully how she turns and pinches the tops and sides.
Okay, I'm gonna put them in the oven. And then they'll bake in 30 to 40 minutes.
Okay, 1 to 4. This is 6 loaves of bread in the oven ready to be baked at 375 for 30 to 40 minutes. They cook them, but I don't want to undercook them. They'll be doughy.
Log, now bread. Here's the final result. Have a nice day.
Great.
That's about all I've got to say. Now, let's look at a 3-dimensional view.
Give me that.
We're finished.
Done.